He said if I wasn't prepared to put him first, he didn't ever want to see me again.
But, Rach, think of it like there's plenty more fish in the sea.
I don't want a fish. I want a boyfriend.
But statistically, fish are much more reliable than boyfriends.
Look, it doesn't matter. I'm never going to fancy anyone ever again.
Not even a fish.
Look, John, I know you're only trying to make me feel better, but it's really not working.
Okay. Okay, I've done my bit and it didn't work, so someone else can have a go now.
The best cure for a broken heart, I always find, is chocolate.
What?
Lots of chocolate. Better than a boyfriend.
How'd you work that one out?
Because it's reliable and it always makes you feel good. You know, you don't have to keep telling chocolate that it looks nice. You don't have to laugh at its bad jokes. It's always there for you when you need it. In the drawer. And boys, I just don't fit in the drawer. No. And chocolate, don't keep farting in front of you all the time.
Thanks, Anne. It's a good try.
I think I saw a smile just then.
Well, there's a start. And who knows? In a few days, that could turn into a laugh.
Yeah, in about 20 years' time, she'll probably get over him completely.
Why don't we have a great big party, invite loads of blokes for Rachel to get off with, so she'll forget about Matt.
Enough about Rachel. How about inviting her some girls?
You're not heartbroken.
If it means me meeting girls, I think I could be heartbroken, all right?
No. Let's have a party, but not for us. Let's have one for Jimmy Bob. Look, he thinks his dad's coming tomorrow, but he's not. So why don't we try and make it the best party he's ever had?
Fantastic. I'll try and find a bloke for Rach.
Let's make a list. Crisps, peanuts, chocolate buttons.
Tall, dark, handsome, tanned.
Twiglets, jellies.
Nice teeth, short hair, fast car.
What is love?
This is aversion therapy.
What are you talking about?
At the minute, when you think of Matt, you think of the good times, and you get upset, right?
Right.
So the purpose of this is to make it unpleasant for you to think of him, so then you won't think of him. Is that clear?
About as clear as a blackboard in a broom cupboard on a dark night with the lights off.
Oh, get on with it.
Okay, we're going to ask you questions, yeah? And every time you say Matt's name, Job is going to hit you on the foot. And then gradually, you'll associate Matt with a sharp pain, and then you won't think of him anymore. Do you get it?
I'm not sure.
Okay, you get the hang of it. Right, first question. Who are you thinking about?
Matt.
Ow! That hurt!
It has to hurt, that's the point. Otherwise it won't work.
Okay, right, next question. In all the world, what would you like most?
I'd like to see Matt.
Ow!
Yeah, and if you had a massive party here with all your friends, you'd be really happy, wouldn't you?
No.
Why not?
Well, Matt wouldn't be here. Ow! Joe!
This ain't working.
Maybe I should hit her harder.
You dare.
Rachel, look, this is for your own good. If you won't concentrate, you're never going to get over it.
I can't concentrate. My foot hurts.
Look, do you want to get over him or do you want to walk around for the rest of your life being miserable?
Of course I want to get over it, but I still want use of both my feet.
We're just going to have to try something else.
So, here we are in the middle of the street trying to find a new boyfriend for Rachel.
Hello.
Oh, hi there.
At last. We're doing a survey on American boys, and we'd just like to ask you a few things.
Okay.
What kind of girls do you like?
Tall blondes.
That's the wrong answer.
Wait, can I get another go?
No!
I like brunettes.
Brunettes. That's good. And what do you think of the name Rachel?
No, I hate it. My sister's name Rachel, and we fight all the time.
How about the name Tina?
Yeah, I like Tina.
Tina, we're not doing this for you.
I know. So, what names do you like?
Beverly. Now there's a cute name.
Do you think Rachel will change her name to Beverly?
Hi there. What can I do for you?
Hi, yeah, I'd like some parts for an 834 pickup.
Oh, sure thing.
Right, I need a carburetor hose, a gasket set, some points, some spark plugs, and a nice smile.
I'm sorry?
Nothing. It's just some washer type thingies, some shiny metal bits, and a little gizmo that goes round and round really, really fast.
Okay. Three funny little washer type thingies, a bunch of widgets, one what's his name, a gizmo that goes around really, really fast, a pipey thing, some wiry stuff, and I'm afraid we're fresh out of stoplight bulbs.
That's amazing. Thanks.
Oh, you're welcome.
By the way, do you like brunettes?
Huh? Come on, Hannah.
I can't reach. Stand up higher.
I'm already standing on tiptoes.
Wait a minute.
Look, we can't wait for your legs to grow. Hang on a minute. I'll get a chair.
Oi! What are you doing?
Paul, have you seen Jimmy Bob?
No.
I'm really worried. I told him his dad couldn't come to his birthday party and he got really upset and he ran off.
Oh, don't worry. We'll help find him. Hey, guys!
What's up?
Jimmy Bob's gone missing. We better help look for him.
Do you know where he's gone? He could be anywhere, down by the sea, up in the hills. I don't know. Oh, nothing terrible's happened to him.
Guys, what's Hannah doing hanging from a tree?
Oh, no.
What'd you leave me for, you great hoot?
Right. Now then, these are the four search zones. Here, 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 and... here. We'll fan out from the central point here and move through your respective zones here.
What is he talking about? He thinks he's Captain Mannering.
Right. Okay, Rachel, you will take on zone A. Bradley and Tina will take on zone B. Hannah, Joe and Paul will take on zone C. And I will take on zone D. We'll move in a clockwise direction, end up back at base here. Right. Any questions?
Yeah. This doesn't look like me. I'd never wear a hat like that. I mean, that is just so lame.
Shut up, Bradley. Right, okay. Synchronized watches.
I don't have a watch. Synchronized freckles, then.
I've got one that looks like Robbie Williams from the side.
Near enough.
Okay, guys. Good luck, and hey, be careful out there.
He has flipped.
Barking.
Off his tiny trunk. Thank you.